have a seat. I do have information to share. You do. Wonderful. Now, everyone is milling about. I think as long as we act as though everything is normal, no one will suspect anything. Would you like to play a game of cards? It is a little bit less suspicious than sitting here speaking in hushed voices. Yes. All right. Did you get any rest? Not really. Although I did sleep maybe 2 hours. Better than none. You know how to... Wonderful. Alright. So you did manage to speak with Mr. Harker. I see. Did you learn anything of interest? I assumed his alibi might be a little bit strange. He does appear to be a fairly strange man. No, I need to write this down. I apologize. We need a break here. I know we just began the game. Writing letters about the use of horses during times of war. And what? To whom were these letters addressed? There is an organization for this. What is the name of the organization? Stop Equine. United. Is this an England-based organization, or... It is indeed. He was writing letters to Stop Equine Warfare United, related to the use of horses, because he believed... Does that make sense? Did he say what else he was doing? I apologize. Yes, I will pick my cards back up. I see. So he had assistance with the bags and was writing letters. But he was struggling to write the letters because the joints in his fingers were sore. Goodness gracious. I don't mean to jump to conclusions here because we still don't have all of the information, but I must say that I strongly doubt Mr. Harker had anything to do with this because I strongly doubt Mr. Harker has anything to do with anything related to physical activity. I did learn something. Take your turn and then I'll tell you what I found out. You got lucky. Yes, I did speak to Bartolomeo. I did not get a chance to speak with our French friend as of yet. I did learn something potentially interesting. Allow me to consult my note. I attempted to transcribe what he was saying. However, he was in a fairly excitable state. Madonna Santa. Yes, this was it. He was rather perturbed, perplexed. Yes, confused in a very negative way. He said that he heard a horrible sound. It's difficult to transcribe exactly what he meant. No, it's more so the tone in which he exclaimed it. He said that it was a sound like nothing he had ever heard before. It was very disturbing, very disruptive. He is uncertain where the sound originated. No, something, yes, it would have been close to the time based on, yes, he said that it sounded something akin to the slaughter of an animal in the presence of the animal's mother, if the mother were capable of experiencing human emotions and expressing them as some sort of human-animal hybrid and screaming them. Yes, it was a rather specific description. It does indeed sound horrible. I did not hear it. Did you hear anything that sounded like a human-animal hybrid screaming in a human-slash-animal voice, caterwaul sound? I suppose I can ask. Yeah. Well, I will make a note to ask Mademoiselle. I'm not even certain how to phrase this question. I will figure something out. Did Mr. Harker mention any sort of sound? Oh, he was listening. I don't understand. What was he listening to? We have no power. I see. He was... I'm beginning to wonder if inviting him was good for his health. I think having an imagination is important, and as writers, I knew I would win at some point. As writers, it is important that you have imaginations, and writers can be rather eccentric. However, is it really healthy for him to not hear sounds because he was listening to orchestras in his mind? I think this is a fair question to consider. I'm calling it luck, not skill. I suppose I should make a note of that too, though. Mr. Harker, no reported sounds. Music in his mind. I don't wish to be cruel. I'm simply saying that this is bizarre. Goodness. No, you shuffle this one. Well, no, and that's the thing that confused me. I didn't hear it, but it doesn't sound like Felix. I've never known Felix to sound animalistic or Well, similar to what was described. Right, I'm thinking it could have been unrelated. Yeah. No. Yes, I am going to talk to her later. I just don't want her to be suspicious. She's acted a little bit odd. I know you weren't at breakfast. Oh, I suppose I have to tell you about breakfast as well. Are you sure that you shuffled these correctly? I am a skilled card player. I think maybe you're cheating. I'm not sure I trust this. Right, breakfast. My apologies. No, I don't wish to quit the game because I am losing. Goodness gracious. No manners you have. Breakfast was... Where were you? I am going to make a note of this. Well, why didn't you tell me that to begin with? You broke into Mr. Harker's room. Why would you do such a thing? Oh, no, no, no. I'm not upset that you broke in. It's just I wish you would have told me so I could come with you. Did you find anything noteworthy? Oh, you found his actual notes. He truly did have letters to the equine group. I see. What sort of herbs? Do you recognize any of the herbs? I suppose that makes sense. He is always complaining about various ailments. Although I wonder, it is possible that there is some toxicity. But I don't. No, I'm not certain. I think it's important to remember potential toxicity, but I don't believe we need to be concerned about Mr. Harker. Let me modify that statement. I believe we need to be deeply concerned about Mr. Harker's mental state. However, I do not believe we need to be concerned about Mr. Harker being violent or murderous. And breakfast. It was strange. Bartolomeo ate quite a lot. It was difficult with no... Exactly. We had the candles. I just used the fire to cook. Yeah. Boiling water. Oh my goodness. Well, Mr. Harker did drink quite a lot of tea, so I had to keep putting the kettle over the fire, and it was... Yes, I didn't get to eat very much, but he ate some fruits. But he said that he was allergic to quite a few of them. At this point, I'm not even certain. Mademoiselle Adami, she did not eat anything. But she drank a considerable amount of wine. She also sat next to Bartolomeo, and she was very... No, no, quite the opposite. In fact, she did bring out her hysterical sort of routine a little bit when I mentioned Felix, but she was quite happy, smiling a lot, leaning her body into him. It was an uncomfortable display. You must be cheating. I'm writing this down. You are a card game cheater. I don't believe you. Nobody gets that lucky. Yes, I will play one more. Yes, I'm going to shuffle these. So she was... Yes, it did appear that she was smitten with him, but he really seemed not to be paying much attention. No, he ate quite a lot. Very, very significant amount of cheese. Very significant amount. He did have some of the fruits. And then the fruits that Mr. Harker didn't finish because of his allergies. But Romeo ate them. He had one glass of wine, but he was drinking tea as well. No, he said that he slept through the night. No, she said that she couldn't sleep a wink because she was devastated and frightened, and she needed a man to take care of her and protect her. No, I do not believe that subtlety is a strength of hers. Yes. No, Mr. Harker was the last to arrive, but I suspect it was because he had to use the stairs, and he is quite physically incapable in, well, every way. Yes. I managed to win two rounds. Better than none. Yes, I am going to talk to her. I don't know if it's worth it to do it now, because she has been rather testy. I do believe she needs to eat because she drank a large amount of wine. I may speak to her. Is a good point. It may make her more open. Right, well, you... I think that might be a good idea. If you can get into Bartholomew's room. Right. I'm not. Oh, you are. My concern is that he said he wanted a nap at some point during the day. Yes, so he may come in unexpectedly. I think it might be too risky. Yes. I think it might be best if you mingle amongst everyone, and I can attempt to find time to talk to her. Yes. Although, it may be best... No, I was thinking a little bit later. In the comfort of her room, maybe she will drink a little bit more wine later. Yes. I think I'm going to talk to her tonight. Tomorrow morning, maybe we can have another meeting of the minds. Yes. But don't try to break into any of the rooms. No, not until we talk to her. go, and I will clean up the cards and just act natural.